course, which you know, the dissenting viewpoint, Miss Thelma Fogie. Miss Fogie?
Fogie.
Tom, speak up, will you? I can't hear you when you're mumbling.
I said, Your Honor.
Oh, okay. Oh, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm really alarmed at the lies and deceit being spread by our pastor. In his last sermon, he said, and I quote, "Therefore, go and make me disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely I am with you always, even to the very ends of the age." Well, what do you think of that?
Think of what? That's exactly what it does say in the Bible.
Ladies and gentlemen, can you see how pervasive this attack is on the Bible? Our pastor is even fooling our announcer here.
What do you mean? He's fooling me?
All right, Mr. Smarty Pants. Okay, so if Jesus really said this, if he really said, "Surely I will be with you always," what about the rest of us?
I don't get it. What are you talking about?
Okay. Suppose for just a minute, Jesus really said, "Surely I will be with you always." Who is this person named Shirley anyway? Is Jesus talking about just one person named Shirley? Or is he saying that he will be only with those people whose name is Shirley? First of all, I looked it up in a concordance. I found a woman named Ruth, one named Esther. I even found a woman named Priscilla, but I couldn't find any Shirley. But regardless, why would Jesus say that he would only be with women? That is preposterous. It's just another example of our pastor playing fast and loose with the Bible. It's time to find ourselves another pastor.
Now wait just a minute here.
Do you mind? I'm doing an editorial here.
Listen, just listen to this if you would for a moment. Matthew 28, 19 and 20 says, "Surely I will be with you always." Not "surely I will be with you always." It's an adverb, not a proper name.
Oh, wow. I am so sorry. But there is something else that troubles me that I really need to talk about. I'm really alarmed at the lies and deceit being spread by our pastor. In his last sermon, he said, and I quote, "Therefore, there is now no commendation for those who are in Christ Jesus." Well, I have just one thing to say to our pastor. If he doesn't think there is any commendation for those who are in Christ Jesus, then exactly what is it when our names are entered into the book of life? If that's not commendation, what is it? What is our pastor looking for anyway? Does he want his name on a theater marquee? Yeah. Now playing in heaven, Pastor Big Mouth. Or maybe he would rather have his name in 6-foot-high letters dragging behind one of those paper or Piper cups over the football stadium. I can envision it now. Pastor Windbag has been saved. Or maybe he'd rather have his name flashed from the flashcard section at halftime. Yay, Pastor Heresy. Go, Pastor Hotshot. Or maybe he'd rather have his name on TV. Yeah, that's it. And now here's the 5-day forecast. Late night and early morning clouds along the coast, clearing before noon, and Pastor Big Shot will finally make it into heaven. For crying out loud, how much more commendation does our dingbat pastor want, anyway?
Thelma, I believe if you listen very carefully to the tape, the quote was, "Therefore, there is now no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus."
Oh, so I don't need my bonfires?
No, I'm afraid you don't.
Oh, never mind. I'm so embarrassed. embarrassed